Hey guys, it's Phantom's Lexus Center here, back again with another Phantom's Lexus Center video, and take a sip of this coffee. Today, I bring you the Christmas series, and by the way, happy early new year, and happy late Christmas. I sadly wasn't here to continue the Christmas series on Christmas Day, because on Christmas Day, I was moving, and now we're settled in our new house. And you're probably like, Phantom's Ex Listener, are you ever going to stop moving? Well, now we finally settled in a house where there's no one to bother, no old man to bother you, because I will explain this in a live. I'm planning to go live tonight, but I'll be whispering like a tiny little mouse, like squee, 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 squee. So you will barely be able to hear me, or I will have my headphones on. So today I bring you the Christmas series, and today I'm doing Mikey, because best for last, bestie. And I hope you guys enjoy this video. By the way, I'm doing a lot better with my mental health, physical health, and self-care. I've been watching a lot of YouTube shorts. Like, okay, let's replace TikTok with YouTube shorts. And a lot of women have been, you know, making my positivity go up. Even non-binaries who also do like makeup and everything. I'll explain that in the live or at the end of the video. Anyway, cutting this conversation short, my Instagram, Wattpad, Discord link server, and songs that I use will all be in the description below. I hope my phone doesn't run out of battery. Let's go! Actually, funny story before we start narrating. I was trying to get my gallery to do the widget thing again. And since I updated my gallery, since I'm on Xiaomi or Redmi, the phone, it's kind of a copy of iPhone, it's really good too. And since it was updated, it does not do the widget thing again, and I wanted to put my little pictures up again, and then I accidentally enabled the storage. Of course, that's my whole entire gallery and then my storage. And then once I came back and I lost half of my gallery. So everything now is out of order, but I'm learning to cope with my OCD and stuff like that. So it's okay. This picture is actually out of order, but it still says the date. It's completely confusing. I think it's just my phone that's glitching. But anyway, getting straight into the story and taking a sip of this coffee. It was Christmas Day. You thought you were going to be spending that Christmas alone again. Since you didn't have many friends, neither did your family come over because they lived so far away. So you went back home after a long day of work at the cafe. You actually got a little gift from the cafe, surprisingly. They gave you some coffee and a free coffee or drink of your choice. You had a few snacks too. They asked if you had any pets and gave you a small little cat cup. As you got home, you sat down, you put the coffee in the kitchen, and you went back to your cat. You gave the cat cup to your cat and said, "It was a long day, Fluffball, trust me. Today, all I did was work. And trust me, there were so many customers because of Christmas, and so many people getting so many free drinks or discounts because some people have their, you know, it's a blessing that they're born on Christmas Day." You lay back, letting out a loud grunt. Your cat, crawling up on your stomach, starting to make bread, quote unquote. You chuckled. "Hey, that tickles," you say. You looked at the T-phone you had on your work desk. "What are the turtles doing at this hour?" you wondered. Your cat meowed. "Should I check on them?" you tilted your head. Your cat little tail went up, meaning a little sign of yes. You grabbed your T-phone and started texting each and every single one of them. The only one who replied was Mikey. Mikey replied it with, "Hey dude, what's up?" as usual, with a little heart. You say, "Hey Mikey, are you available for Christmas today? I didn't want to spend my Christmas alone." He said, "Yeah, all my brothers are not available today. Leo's doing training, and he's actually going to Japan with Master Splinter for Christmas. Donnie's spending his Christmas with Casey in April, of course. And Raph is spending his Christmas with Spike. I was left alone." "We could spend our Christmas together," you were talking over the phone, by the way. You smiled, blushing a little bit. Yeah, of course. Do you want me to come over for a little bit, and then later on at night you could come over to my place? You hear him chuckle softly. Yeah, this sounds like a plan. You fix your things, your little bag, make sure to take that hot shower, and grab your cat because you did not want to leave Fluffball alone any more or any longer than a second. You went down to the lair, finding Mikey, of course, waiting for you at the doorway, greeting you with a big bear hug. Oh my god, I missed you. I missed you so much. You blushed. Whoa, take it easy, Mikey, you said. I have Fluffball with me. He let go of you immediately as he heard the name Fluffball. Oh, I'm sorry. Did I crush Fluffball? He looked and sounded worried. Fluffball popped his head out of his little cat bag, meowing. Oh, thank God. Hey, Fluffball, he said, giving him chin scratches. You and Fluffball get along very well. I can see why Fluffball and Raph don't get along. He chuckled. He smiled, saying, yeah, they don't get along very well. But when we're not around, I saw this little moment where Fluffball was making bread on Raph's chest. Even though it's not even that fluffy, he's a turtle. Fluffball let out a angry-ish meow. Hey, I have proof. You chuckled and said, hey, let's not get Fluffball angered. Let's just play some video games meanwhile. I'll order pizza. He jumped up happily. Yes, pizza. You guys sat on the couch playing a few video games. Mario Kart, classic. You got out your Nintendo.
Man, I wish I had a Nintendo.
Lucky. You got out your Nintendo and y'all did some Wii Sports. He looked at you and said, no fair, you know all the moves already. You chuckled, practice before Christmas. Cheater. You give him a little nudge. He gave you a little nudge on the foot. Almost knocking you over, surprisingly. You gasped.
Mikey. What? That's not cheating.
He smiled. I let it slide. The pizza got there.
Yes, I'll go get the pizza. What's the password?
The pizza guy replied, cowabunga.
Correct. Pass the pizza. Thank you. He's dip.
He came back. You were laughing your butt off, saying the secret password is cowabunga.
Dude, I made that password. So, cowabunga.
He ate his pizza. And the surprising thing was there was one last slice of pizza inspired by Reinhardt, or however you say his name.
Who's gonna have the last slice?
You raise your hand, controlling the game with your other. Me, of course. You went to grab it, and then Mikey, of course, grabbing it with his other hand too. You two looked at each other and said, huh? He said,
nuh-uh, no way you're having this slice of pizza.
You said, Mikey, you had like two boxes of pizza before me. I only had, what, five slices? He said,
fair enough.
You sigh and said, how about we just share? You glared.
Fine, sharing is caring.
You two put one of the ends, with the cheese, of course, on your mouths while pausing the game. Nom nom nom. And then as soon as it got to your mouths, you pulled away because you got too shy.
Save the best part for last.
Mikey was also blushing. He looked away and said,
you okay over there?
You nodded. Yeah, it's getting a little late. Don't you think we should head over to my place? He nodded and said,
I may not be the one with the best cleaning, but I'll clean up the place a little bit first.
You nod. You two clean up the place. You grab Fluffball, who was surprisingly playing with Spike. Wait, Spike isn't home. Let's just say he was just playing around with Metalhead. You turn Metalhead off, and you guys went over to your place.
Mikey had shining little stars in his eyes when he walked into your apartment. Take a sip of this coffee.
Whoa, your place looks amazing.
You shrugged and chuckled. It isn't much.
What do you mean by it isn't much? I'm the one who did most of the decorating in the lair. Credit to Donnie, too. He's the one with the Christmas spirit still. Raph and Leah didn't really care much. Master Splinter was okay with it, though. As long as Master Splinter is okay with it, then we're all okay with it.
He sat down on the couch waiting for you. He started to make hot cocoa. He helped you out. And then you two sat down with a comfy blanket and you said, "So, you want to watch Christmas movies for now? Then we can make gingerbread cookies." He nodded with a cute little happy smile. You two watched a few Christmas movies, his favorite being, okay, hear me out, that man would love, and I mean love children's holiday movies, especially not Dr. Seuss the movie, but either The Grinch or either Home Alone. I feel like he would mainly like The Grinch, like the remake of Grinch, because it's so cartoony and silly. But anyway, he was the one almost half asleep. You poked him a little bit on his cheek and said, "Mikey?
I'm awake. Sorry. That hot cocoa kicked in real quick."
You chuckled and said, "Guess who I brought over?" He said,
"What?"
Tilting his head. You took out Ice Cream Kitty from the freezer.
Meow.
He gasped.
"Little Ice Cream Kitty."
"You taste so good, my little Ice Cream Kitty." Ice Cream Kitty licked both of your faces. He held Ice Cream Kitty and said,
"Do you have any ice?"
And you said, "I brought a whole pack of ice for that kitty." He gets out the ice packs and puts it on Ice Cream Kitty. You two started making the gingerbread cookies.
"Whoa, you have some skill with that icing."
You smiled. "Thanks. Here, if you're going to make Raph, make him look angry, not smiling." You helped him out, going behind him, gently grabbing his hands. He's never felt you that close before.
"Thank you."
He was a complete tomato. You smiled. "No problem." "I mean, I'm a baker myself." You continued making your Leo cookie. He was still blushing while his hand shakingly decorating Raph. You looked over at his hand and said, "You okay? You look a little shaky."
"Yeah, just have something in my mind."
You cupped his face and said, "Mikey, if you have anything negative on your mind, you know you should just tell me. We're best friends." He looked at you with his cute little blue eyes. And just, he stared. Wait, isn't Leo the one with blue eyes? Hold on. Okay, so basically Mikey has like lighter blue eyes, like baby blue eyes, basically. Oh my god, rain. And Leo has kind of like ocean eyes. Can't stop staring at those ocean eyes. And he was,
he said, stuttering, I don't have anything on my mind. I'm just thinking.
He said, "Exactly, you're thinking about something." He just like clenched his fist a little bit. I gotta take a sip of this coffee. He clenched his fist a little bit, not of anger, but of being nervous. He gently grabbed your shoulders, moving his hands up to your face, kissing you. Surprisingly, Ice Cream Kitty and Fluffball put a mistletoe somehow right above you two. Teamwork makes the dream work.
Here,
he said before kissing you. Small kissing sounds, I'm sorry if this will make you uncomfortable.
after you two kissed.
It was a very, very lovey, passionate kiss, by the way.
You two stared at each other. You stared into Mikey's eyes like, what just happened? And I enjoyed that at the same time kind of look. Mikey, of course, stopped cupping your face and looked away, covering his face. And all you heard was basic squeals. You turned him around and said, Mikey, why'd you do that?
Look, listener, I know we've been close and flirty and everything, and I know we've been dating for a little bit, but I just wanted to give you a Christmas gift that was really special, and just for you and me.
He stared like passionately, like a lovey-dovey stare into your eyes. You started blushing like hell. You cupped his face, just like, and you said, oh, Mikey, you're already like the most special Christmas gift I could have ever gotten. Plus, your company's already enough. You kissed his forehead.
Thank you.
After you two ate the cookies, surprisingly, Mikey aggressively ate Raphael. That sounds so inappropriate. And then you seemed like you were getting sleepy, so Mikey picked you up bridal style. Of course, Fluffball found a way to put Ice Cream Kitty in the freezer. And then he carried you to your room. Of course, he took off his Santa outfit. He's not naked, it's just a turtle. And then he laid down next to you and said,
Christmas cuddles?
He reached out like a child, wanting to hold you in his arms. Sure. He snuggled you.
This could have been the best Christmas I've ever had throughout the years in New York.
He said in a really, really soft voice. Which he's done that soft voice before, only 2 times, my last Mikey videos. Hearing it now, during a really special time, makes you really sleepy. And you say, yawning.
Yeah, it really was a special Christmas.
You give him a little kiss on the nose.
No, let's just sleep, Mikey.
It's late. Fluffball snuggled in between you two. Meow.
Yeah, he needs some sleep. Good night, sweetheart.
And that's all for today, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure to like, comment, and subscribe. It's not even midnight yet. And my Instagram, Discord link server, Wattpad, and the songs that I use will all be in the description below. I hope this wasn't too cringy or too uncomfortable. I made sure to not do too many kissing sounds. I'm actually going to be double uploading, or if I can, triple upload tonight. And I was thinking of doing maybe My Hero Academia Christmas special, because I've been working on my Midoriya voice like this. This really was a special Christmas. I do have to admit. Just us two, here, in the snow, under the mistletoe. What do you guys think? Comment down below. Anyway, we're really close to 4K, my goal. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Mwah, mwah, mwah.